To the vlog. Well, folks, the cold weather has descended upon us like a legion of locusts. It is like 40 degrees outside. Remember, during these cold months of the year, your guitar may experience some changes. Make sure to humidify your acoustic instruments and monitor your action on your guitars regularly, because you will see some fluctuations. That was just a public service announcement. You know, when the weather gets dry, it does affect wood. So, just wanted to put that out there. Now, this is an incredibly busy week. Not as busy as next week will be. I don't want to let the cat out of the bag on any of that, but next week is going to be a real barn burner. So, this is what we're going to do this week. Probably going to take a look at rehearsal. Believe it or not, magically, Outer Loop, my band that I currently play guitar and sing for, has a freaking gig on the books. So we are trying to get our act together after a month-long hiatus. The guys had some personal things going on that they needed to take care of. No big deal. I've been playing with these guys for like 17 years, so if they need a month off, it's no sweat off my back. But so we do have a gig coming up. Exciting. So we are getting ready for that. We also have, we are doing some finishing touches on our recording, Music from the Eagle Nebula. We had some last minute snafus, but we are working to correct those things. By the way, if you would like a copy of our last album, Half Moon Theory, you can contact me at theouterloopband@gmail.com, or you can simply just PayPal me $3 and I'll send you the damn record, okay? On the vinyl front, I do have some records I would like to show you today. I will be brief because I know all of you are not vinyl music fans. Most of you are probably here for the guitar content. That said, these are all somewhat guitar related vinyl records. The first one that I would like to show you is this Old Ventures album. I believe this is from 1967. Features this lovely lady on the front here, who in 1971 was the Playboy. That said, this is still in the shrink wrap, very clean, and it has all of the best Ventures songs on it. Apache, Walk Don't Run, Wipeout. Let's see what else it has on here. Oh, and Pipeline. Duh. Pipeline. It's an awesome tune. You should learn those songs. There's a reason why there's so many old guys who are Ventures fanatics trying to buy Masri guitars and stuff, you know? It's because they were deadly wicked on the guitar. So, the Ventures. Really cool album. In very, very good condition, by the way, if I say so myself. Now, we're going to go to the opposite end of the spectrum. Very bad condition. David Bowie's Ziggy Stardust. Pick this up. It's on Dynaflex. It's Canadian release. And it is beat to the death. Turns out, everyone used their Ziggy Stardust album as like a weed tray or something, because every single one of these that is online or currently for sale in Discogs or whatever is just nasty. I mean, beat up. People must have loved this thing when it came out because they listened to it a lot and abused the crap out of it. Mick Ronson on guitar. Really cool record. Obviously, you know, Ziggy Stardust, Rock and Roll Suicide is on here. Killer album. Get it. Check it out. You need to hear it. It's a classic, folks. It's a classic. Now, also this week, I bought some more Stevie Ray Vaughan. This, in fact, is the Soul to Soul album. And I bought this essentially for one song, and it's Ain't Gonna Give Up on Love. It's a really killer kind of slow blues number. Oddly enough, this record features Stevie on the front with a 335. It's kind of a curveball there. Really good album. Obviously, the record is in mint condition. That's right, folks. Moving right along to Def Leppard's best album. That's right. High and Dry. It's their first record, and it is the best. You know, if you ask me, you know, mileage may differ depending on who you're talking to. But in my opinion, High and Dry is their best record because it's a straight rocker, folks. Check it out. High and Dry. Really good album from Def Leppard. And last but not least, boom, the Beatles, Rubber Soul, first press, near mint condition, awesome record. There's nothing I can really say about this that hasn't already been said. Just get Rubber Soul, check it out. It's like my fourth favorite Beatles record, but when you come across something that's just this immaculate, you have to get it. Now, moving out of the murky waters of vinyl hunting. Let's see what else is on the docket. Stranger Things is out this week. I love that show. I am going to a concert this week. You will probably see some footage from that. It is Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn. So that should be rather enjoyable. If you don't know who Bela is, he is a banjo virtuoso. And Abigail, who is his wife, plays in the traditional claw hammer style on the banjo. And together they make up a pretty awesome banjo duo.
It's Kentucky, folks. We do these types of things. Banjos. You know? Probably going to be some hijinks involved, among other things. So, stay tuned. Check it out. Like, subscribe, tell a friend, leave a comment. You know. Drop me a line. But I think we should probably get on with the vlog now. I've just been going on and on and on for moments. 3:35 at practice this week. Check it out. I don't like to call it practice. It's rehearsal. 3:35 at rehearsal this week. Check it out. Over and out.
characters on the bridge.
Down on me. Thank you.